Building with stone is hard, heavy, and slow. The toughness and brute force needed have ground many a macho man to dust.
I think any stonemason moves stone all day long, like Sisyphus. You feel like it's a never-ending thing. You're just continually moving material. An average day for me is about 5 tons of material.
Thea Alvin, one of New England's most celebrated stone builders.
My ballerina. Barely balanced.
So, how does a nice girl find her way into what is arguably the world's second oldest profession?
It started a really long time ago. I was born a girl, and I think that my father wanted a boy, and he was a stonemason, and he taught me what he knew.
Alvin's work, an artful blend of whimsy and functionality.
I like stone because it's big, it's old, it's heavy, and I like to make it look like it's fluid, that it's doing these lines of impossible shapes, and I like to think that those lines are feminine.
Winters on the little farm in Morrisville, Vermont are largely given over to planning projects and stone carving with her partner, Michael Klucke, but a peek inside Alvin's combination art gallery slash hayloft shows that the impulse to build never hibernates.
What does a stonemason do in the winter? We do what we do in the summer, but with different materials.
Alvin travels the world, often enlisting local groups to help her construct. And wherever she goes, stone arches seem to follow.
I love building arches. They're held up by gravity. They're really strong. They're unlikely. They're delicate. And I think that all those words or terms are indicative of who I am. Full of paradox. I don't know. They're beautiful.
I don't know if I get any of these things out of here or not. There we go. There we are, discovery. There we are.
Richard Foreman wants to show us the harding, or small stones farmers would use to fill a double-wide cultivation stone wall.
Notice that these are all rounded here, but these little rocks are angular. I'm destroying a stone wall here.
Foreman is a professor of landscape geology at Harvard, which is... what exactly?
It's the ecology of what you see out an airplane window. You know, you look down there, what's the spatial arrangement? What's the pattern? It involves the human aspects, the natural aspects, the water movement, the animal movement, and so forth. It's really important.
Foreman's office may be at the Graduate School of Design, but one of his favorite laboratories is the Minuteman National Historical Park out in Lexington, Lincoln, and Concord.
Now I can use my high-tech probe here, and maybe, there, feel that, see that? I hit a stone about this far down.
Great efforts have been taken to return this landscape to the way it looked when the Minutemen chased the British back to Boston in 1775. The park has rebuilt miles and miles of stone wall, but not all have been restored.
Well, at first glance, it looked like just a pile of rocks, doesn't it? Yeah, just a mess.
Richard Foreman's trained eye can see things many can't.
I'm a landscape detective. I'm an eco-detective. And so I see clues in the land to the past, to the present.
Case in point, this seemingly random scattering of rocks in the woods.
There's another one right there. And so forth. And I've done this. There's another one right there.
The presence of foundation stones under the soil tells Foreman there was, in fact, an old cultivation stone wall here long, long ago. He thinks the old walls along the Battle Road tell an important historical story.
Stone walls are part of our heritage. I think of them as just being descriptors of a civilization, that is, the markings of a civilization.
And back to Thea Alvin, we have some sad news to report. She actually recently had a fire and she lost her barn, her animals, her tools, her work, and half of her home. Mm.
She is, however, rebuilding, which is good news. In fact, she's having a community barn raising in June. The public is invited to help her out, and she's also taking donations through a GoFundMe page. So give her a hand if you can.
Give her a hand. Ted's puzzled by pre-colonial walls. Native Americans may have built them, but why? The answer when we return.